Okay, I just want to give you some kind of my viewpoint, and also I'm the co-founder of this networking. I'm helping with Catherine, so we are hoping this is a very good moment for to share my side of stories. So I just wanted to welcome everybody here, and also from the major country of Africa. So it's my very pleasure to be convened today for the Korea Africa Startup Network, which is we call it as KASN. This gathering marks a meaningful milestone in fostering collaboration and innovation by providing a platform for sharing knowledge and networking and capacity building between Korea and Africa, each countries. So I'd like to propose to share the vision and objective and activities of our network platform. Before this, let me introduce, as Kathleen mentioned, some successful and interesting story of Korean startup build-up and Korean startup stories. So Korea launches official development, which is the UAK Rice Belt, in this last year in July. And this program is designed to alleviate the food shortage on the continent. Korean varieties of rice, such as Tongil rice, we call the Tongilbyeo, and saved the South Korean from starvation in the past, because the Korean War, as a pre-industrial period, most of people acknowledge that the Korea has been developing through the starvation at the very underdeveloped countries, and we continue to develop it through industrial planning and the programs. And before then, at that time, we are very struggling. We have food age problems. So we built, and so they developed, we call the Tongil rice. Then Korean rice can just African climate. This is a very strong and characteristic that can endure the any kind of a climate, or so especially its supply. So they yield 5 to 7 tons per hectare, which is approximately 4 times of the African varieties. This project seeks to share South Korea's rice cultivation experience and supply varieties to African countries, and is expected to emerge as a major part of President Yoon Suk-yeol's current administration's idea to cooperate with Africa. And also, there is another story, it's very interesting, A-Belt, a smart farm solution. Probably we have to very focus on smart farm and the architect because of African continental is a very the plentiful and a good opportunity for this launching this kind of smart farm technology. So this is it. That's why I brought up these examples, which is a smart farm solution. It founded in January 2019 and have succeeded in entering Vietnam market in just 3 years. This startup develops solution for easier smart farm operations utilizing AI, drones, big data, and the Internet of Things, which is called IoT. Its goal is to help anyone grow high quality crops with easy caring. Two young co-founders of A-Belbu were honored to be selected as Forbes and American Economic Magazine as one of the Forbes 30 under 30 Asian 2023 readers who are bringing about positive change and leading innovation in the Asian Pacific region. A-Belt succeeded in the entering Vietnam market with the help of creative technology solution, which is presents the Koikos innovative technology solution. It applies innovative ideas and technologies from innovators such as prospective entrepreneurs and startup to ODA. This program tries to find solutions to challenges in development cooperation that were deemed difficult to solve. It refers to the project that contribute to an improved effectiveness of developing cooperation projects. There is no reason to say that this successful case is just limited to Vietnam. There is no reason to say that Belbu cannot enter Africa. Africa has been, as we already mentioned, showing the possibility and the capacity to building agricultural business and startup ecosystem. Here are the top 10 African agriculture. Maybe you can show in the. Did you come up with the screen? There's 10 African agriculture startup. Some of them have been probably, you know, they've been successful in their business, but some are struggling in various challenges. But it is clear that Africa is a land of opportunity in agriculture, and there are many points to cooperate because we have some problems. Host has to allow to upload our PPT presentation. But okay, we can go. But there are like 10 agricultural startups. So Hello Tractor, Volvisha Agritech, Comfrey Farmer, and such. There was 10 of them. So funding for the agri-tech sector has expanded across the African continent and is showing annual increase. Notably, in 2020, nearly $60 billion US dollars was raised in Africa's agri-tech sector alone. It represents approximately 9% of the total amount raised by the startup across Africa. Now we can imagine various possibilities of Africa. Korean agricultural startups such as Abelvu can enter African market. This is just a simple example. It can cooperate with African agri-tech startup or companies of a similar nature. With the success of a startup, Africa can dramatically improve the agricultural harvest, which could lead to export to other continents and countries. We can also imagine that this vision will not be limited to only the agricultural area. We can expect various opportunities for other businesses such as fintech, information technology, tourism, and so on, which is a very strong point industry of the Korean companies. What is the key to making this possibility come true? To do business overseas, you need to be fully aware of the need of local market, region, and political and social issues. That's why we are launching this Korea African Startup Network. So Korean startups are still eager for information and knowledge about Africa. Africa welcomes Korea's experience of economic growth. And here we come to know why we are gathering today. KSN is a community that brings together startup, accelerator, investor, legal counselors, and government officials from Korea and Africa. KSN aims to foster collaboration and innovation by providing a platform for knowledge sharing, networking, and capacity building. African startup can leverage the KSAN as a platform to expand to South Korea. By using South Korea as a gateway, the startup can expand to other countries in Asia. KSAN will start the effort to help the Korean African startup ecosystem. Actors in the ecosystem can make a connect point with local government and local accelerator through our KSAN. This network is essential for planning a business model suitable for the local areas in Africa. Now I just want to briefly mention of the objective of our networking. First of all, I would like to propose the primary objective of KSAN. One first objective is to facilitate knowledge exchange. KSAN will serve as a platform for the participant of the Korean African startup ecosystem. We can challenge idea, experience, and best practices in startup ecosystem. And secondly, is to promote collaboration. KSSN will encourage collaboration between Korean and African startup accelerating as investors. It will foster partnership to drive innovation and economic growth. Third, this network tries to support policy development. It will research startup policies and regulation in both Korea and major countries of Africa. This try can provide insight and recommendation to government to create conducive environment for startup. Last but not least, the final objective is to develop acceleration program. KSSN will design and implement acceleration programs that provide startups with necessary resources, mentorships, and networking opportunity to scale up their businesses. Additionally, KSSN will contact startups with potential investors to facilitate future funding opportunities. Now, with the four objectives, KASN plan to do five specific projects and activities. First and foremost, startup seminars and forum can be important place to share knowledge between both partners. KASN will organize regular seminars and forums. This gathering will bring together stakeholders from Korea and Africa. They will also provide a platform for startups to showcase their innovation experiences, share success stories, and learn from industry experts. This event will combat various topics such as technology trend, market insight, and funding opportunities and scale strategies. By facilitating knowledge sharing and networking, KASN aims to inspire and empower startups to grow and succeed. Secondly, we will research startup policies and regulations in Korea and Africa. This research will analyze the strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats of existing policies. Identifying areas for improvement and innovation, it is important to share the finding with government officials and policymakers to inform the development of a supportive and inclusive startup ecosystem. KASN will also collaborate with research institutes such as our institute and the think tanks to produce comprehensive reports and policy briefs. Thirdly, we will try to help both Korean and African startups with accelerating programs. KASN will develop and implement acceleration programs tailored to the needs of startups in Korea and Africa. These programs will provide the startup with mentorships, access to resources and network opportunities, and expose potential investors. KSSN will collaborate with accelerators, incubators, and industrial experts to develop high-quality acceleration programs. This opportunity will address the specific challenges that startups are facing in different sectors and regions. The program also facilitates cross-border collaboration and market entry for startups. Additionally, we are thinking about investor engagement. KASN will actively engage with investors from Korea and Africa, even the other countries around the world, to create investment opportunity for startups. This is improved organizing investor pitch event, matchmaking sections, and investor roadshows. KASN will also provide support to startups in preparing investment pitches, connecting them with relevant investors, and facilitating due diligence processes. By bridging the gap between startups and investors, KASN aims to attract funding and promote the growth of innovative startups in Korea and Africa. Lastly, governance and partnership will be our important activities. We will establish a governance structure comprising representatives from the major participants of the startup ecosystem. This structure will ensure transparency, inclusivity, and effective decision-making within networks. We, KASN, will also seek partnership with relevant organizations, including government agencies, industry associations, universities, and research institutes. These partnerships will enhance their resource and importance of their network. I was showing the blueprint of the network, and I just want to make something now, just come up with a conclusion that not everyone can be in the best global startup ecosystem. It depends on our effort and life circumstances. KASN can offer Korean startups good options and opportunity to grow and succeed in the harsh global business environment. Fortunately, we have many good members who have strengths and experts. With these excellent members, KASN will play a pivotal role in driving entrepreneurship technology transfer and sustained development in Korea and Africa startup ecosystem. I believe our various efforts will be a happy surprise for startups in Korea and Africa. Thank you very much.